COVID-19 has impacted our lives in just about every way imaginable. And in multiple myeloma, sadly, it has very much impacted our ability to conduct clinical trials. Thankfully, now that we are out of the immediate acute phase when many trials were suspended, we actually have been able to work around this in general, where now we've been able to reintroduce studies and bring in new studies, of course, and we can do so in a more careful manner. Many of our clinical trials now are allowing intermittently to have telemedicine visits, which reduces the traffic for patients and makes it a little bit smoother. Some of the questionnaires and the things that we used to have to fill out on paper or physically in person now can be done electronically. So I think in many respects, we've really overcome most of the barriers so that we can continue the outstanding work in clinical trials to provide options for our patients that were not available before. And looking to the future, I hope, even paradoxically in some way, that this may, now that we've developed a more sophisticated telemedicine platform, it may allow us to do more and perhaps reach patients that may not have been reached before. There are already studies and trials under that are being done through telemedicine, not necessarily a drug trial, but quality of life studies, engagement studies, educational studies, different ways that we can enhance a patient's experience and investigate better ways of doing things now that we can do so more fully electronically. When I think of telemedicine and the future in multiple myeloma, I think it will continue to have a role in the long term. I think, much like people think that there will be more virtual meetings, I think we all want to get back to in-person meetings of various types and sizes and shapes. There will always be a component of virtual. And I can think, even in my own practice, and some patients that have quite a long drive to come down to see me, that they will still have to have face-to-face visits, but intermittently, when things are going well, follow-up like visits where the discussion may be limited, I think there will be a role for this so that we can leverage the best of telemedicine and the best of in-person medicine so that the patients can receive the best care possible.